We will start in this video. We will start with chapter 2 of Indian Evidence Act 1872, which is relevancy of fact. Now, relevancy of fact starts with the section 5, which says any evidence can be given in suit and proceeding with respect to existence or non-existence of a fact which is related to fact in issue or relevant fact, which means any evidence can only be given in fact in issue or relevant facts. So fact and issue, we have already discussed, that is anything which is related to right, liability, disability, any fact which is related to right, liability and disability will be considered in fact and issue. Okay, so what are relevant facts? This section 5 says all the things which is stated from section 6 to 55 will be considered as relevant fact or relevancy of facts. So let me read it for you. Evidence may be given in any suit or proceeding of existence or non-existence of every fact and issue or such other facts as are herein declared to be relevant. So question is, which fact will be relevant? Any fact which is stated herein after, which means in this chapter from section 6 to 55. So all the things which is stated in section 6 to 55 will be relevant. Now let's start with section 6 then. Section 6 says any fact which is in the in which forms the part of transaction will be a relevant fact. So the question is, please remember, in this chapter we are trying to understand what is relevant fact, on what fact will be relevant and what fact will be in fact an issue. So, and only on those facts evidence can be given. Section 6 says, let me read it for you. Section 6, please have bear it with you so that it's easier for everybody to understand. Relevancy of fact forming part of same transaction. Facts which are so connected with the fact in issue as to form part of same transaction, where they have occurred with the same time and place or different time and place. So any fact which is connected with fact in issue forming same part of same transaction, what is transaction here? Transaction means group of facts. Transaction means group of facts making any event, right? For example, a person is a husband of other person, which is a fact. So F1 is a fact that they are husband and wife. F2, they are living in a particular house with a particular address. That's a fact 2. Fact 3, neighbors heard fights or voices, distress voices. F3. F4, neighbors saw husband running out of the house with a stain on his clothes, blood stains. F5, afterwards police recovered dead body from the house, that is of wife. F6, there was a knife or there was a gun in the same room with the fingerprints of the husband. So these are facts. These group of facts is a transaction. This F1 to F6, if we add all of them, we will get what? A murder scene or murder, right? Culpable homicide amounting to murder. So that is a transaction. Now this is a criminal in nature. Another group of facts will be if one person asked the other person to deliver 100 trucks of cement, other person have said yes through a mail. F3. F4 is first person have through his bank transferred, let's say, 5 crore rupees to F2's bank. F4. So these are group of facts. Now, when you add these facts, you get a contract, right? Or any other civil nature, any other civil transaction in that nature. So this is a, what is transaction? Group of facts making an event. Event is very important. Event, right? Now, so anything which is said during the event or before the event or after the event will be considered as forming the part of same transaction. Illustrations are given. Illustrations are very important to understand the section. Illustrations is given as, let's say, A is accused of murder of B by beating him. What was said or done before by A or B before the act of beating or after the act, or anything which is heard by or seen by bystanders. Bystander means people who can see that. Everything will be considered as a relevant fact. So any evidence regarding that fact will be considered in court of law. And why? Because it will be relevant. Why it will be relevant? Because section 6 says so. Because they are forming the part of same transaction. In there is a doctrine of res gestae. Res gestae. In English, this is English doctrine which says anything done or said before and after an event will be considered as relevant fact or a fact forming the part of same transaction. Res gestae. Things. This is a Latin word, so the thing in English it is translated as things as done. Right? So the first case in this, so you understand everything which is spontaneously said before the event or during the event or after the event will be considered as res gestae, will be considered as a relevant fact. Which is why? Because it's forming the same transaction. It's within the same transaction. With those facts, we can prove the happening or non-happening of a particular transaction. Right? So, to understand better, let's take examples. Ratten versus Queen is one of the leading cases. Ratten versus Queen. Ratten versus Queen. Okay, in this example what happened is there was a call made by a woman. Earlier, please understand that this is very old case, so earlier you have to call an operator to call somebody. So if I want to call X person, I have to call an operator and I will tell him that I want to make a call to X person. Please dial the number or connect the call. So operator used to do that. Now, what happened is this. A woman called an operator and said, "Get me the police." And her voice was in distress. She was fumbling. She was very, her tone of the voice was very, very, she was in distress basically. And she gave the address, and before she could say anything, the call was cut. Afterwards, when police happened to go there in the house, they found the dead body of the person, of wife. So, but husband claimed, the accused was husband, and husband claimed that it was an accidental shot. Means he accidentally shot his wife. But court said, since there was evidence that operator said that this woman have called and said, get me a police, which means call the police, and she was in distress. So these two facts, that woman calling operator, get me a police, and her tone was in distress, she was not feeling well, that two facts given by operator was considered as a relevant fact as res gestae, and it was admissible. On the basis of these two facts, this husband was convicted. Although operator never saw the husband doing murder directly, he have just heard it. But since it's forming the same transaction, it was accepted. That's Rattan versus Queen. Number two, R versus Burnenfield, if I'm not wrong. Bedingfield. Okay. In this example, what happened is this. In a house, women came out suddenly from particular room, and she met with the aunt. Her throat was bleeding, and she said, "Oh dear aunt, see what Bedingfield have done to me." That was her statement. "Oh dear aunt, see what Bedingfield have done." Bedingfield is the name of the husband. "Bedingfield have done to me." So afterwards it was stated that husband cut the throat of the wife, but husband said no. Whether this will be considered as res gestae, because after the event she said this. Court surprisingly said this will not be considered as a res gestae, because she had a time period from the time her throat was slit and from the time she met the aunt, which was few minutes or few seconds or few minutes. So there was a time duration between the act of cutting throat and meeting the aunt. So there is no possibility we can say that the husband have done so, and they have not recovered the husband at that time. Aunt never saw the husband doing that. Aunt never saw the husband only. So whether this was be considered as gestae or not, court said no. Now on the issue of whether this will be considered as dying declaration, because before dying she said that. Before dying she said Bedingfield have done this to me. Now whether this will be created as dying declaration. Now remember, dying declaration is always considered to be true, because a person who is dying will never say false statement, which is assumption of law. But court said no, this is not a dying declaration, because she could not have got the time to reflect that she will die. So what essentially court said is this: before dying, she had enough time to make up the story, but she never had enough time to reflect that she might die, so that she should say yes. There's a problem here, right? Although R versus Bedingfield was considered to be right judgment, moved on, and then there was another judgment called R versus. In this, please remember, in this it was not considered as res gestae. Right, it was not. In this it was yes, it was considered yes, it is res gestae. In this it was not considered as res gestae. R versus Christie. In R versus Christie, what happened is a person assaulted a boy. After the assault, boy went to home and told the mother that he was assaulted by this ex person in this X manner or Y manner. Mother, in this whole and after the case, mother said this was directly told by the boy, right? Whether it's considered as res gestae, because he told the mother that he did this to me, he assaulted me. Court said no, it will not be considered as res gestae. Why? Because he had enough time to make up the story. Please remember, the whole res gestae concept is this: whether you will have enough time to make any story or not, whether your reaction or your act, your words are spontaneous in nature or not. Because either they are direct consequence in spontaneous nature. Whenever if somebody will slap you or somebody will assault you, the spontaneous nature is there will be some kind of cry, not in a real nature of crying, but some kind of cry or something you will say in pain. That's spontaneous. But after some time you might make a story to make sure that the other person can be arrested. So court do not want to do that. Remember, nobody saw that. This is not direct evidence. It's a fact. We are trying to understand whether this fact is relevant or not. So it can be only relevant if it is said, if it's said there and then. So R versus, this is the concept of res gestae. R versus Christine, court said, there was enough time gap between the actual event and his making of the story or his telling the story to his mother. So because of that, res gestae will not be applicable. Now, please write it down, Rattan versus Queen, R versus Bidding Field, R versus Christie. Now, another case, R versus Foster. In this, what happened is a person saw a vehicle which was going very fast. And after some time, when he reached the destination, he saw that a person was bleeding very heavily, and he said this car had hit me and went right, hit and run case. So it hit me and it ran away. So this third person who have asked this person who is injured now, he said this car have hit me and went away. Please remember, the witness have not seen the actual happening of accident or actual happening of car hitting this ex person, Foster. Okay, he have not seen the person. He have only seen a car. But court said it will be res gestae. Why? Because person is in deep pain at that time. He was hit by car, not hit by, ran over. The car ran over his legs. So it was stated that he was in so distress, he could not have come up, he do not have the mindset to make up the story because he is in distress. Please remember, time period is important, but also the emotional understanding of their main case is now. After everything, court said there is enough confusion with res gestae. We have to come up with something. Rattan versus Regin. Rattan versus Reginum. Court here said, let me for once and all sum up what is res gestae, which I've already told you. Res gestae in this case only says nothing but anything said which has to be spontaneous, or at least there should be no time between the actual event, and there should not be enough time to make stories. So there should be enough spontaneity, there should be spontaneous in nature, and it should not be enough time given so that he can come up with the story. So any person should not make any story. Because of that, res gestae was confined to this thing. I hope you will understand, you already understood what is res gestae and everything. So these are four cases. Now, time and place, there's something related to time and place. It might have happened in the same time in the same place, or it might have happened in the different times and different places. It's not material fact. The only material fact is whether the person had enough time to make up story. If according to judicial mind of a judicial officer, he had no time, or he was in so deep distress that he could not make up the story, as we have seen R versus Foster, then it will be res gestae. Else it won't be a res gestae. Okay, now so that's the concept of section 6. In next video we will move with the section 7 in detail. Thank you very much.